genocide of the starving nation, multinational corporation, genocide of the starving nation.
Yeah! Thank you. Merci beaucoup. All right, thank you. Once again, welcome. It's the same view, a little bit of deja vu going on. So, for the benefit of those of you who weren't standing in exactly the same fucking places a couple of years ago, we are Napalm Death from Birmingham, England, and so. Once again, welcome one and all. Aside from playing this fucking thing, we do have a reason for being here. We have a compilation album out called Coded Smears, another uncommon slur. So naturally, we're going to play a couple of songs from that for you. This one's called Oh So Pseudo. Okay, thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you. How's it get weed? Fucking hell. Right then. I'm going to take you back a couple of albums now. This one's called The Wolf I Feed. Cheers. Merci, thank you once again. Back to that there compilation album I was referencing earlier on. This song, friends, is a song about a world where, curiously, some people would like to live, usually those in power that call the shots. A homogenous world where everybody thinks the same, wears the same fucking clothes, and there are one or two versions of sexuality. What a fucking tedious world that would be to live in. Entirely fucking pointless and just not fucking worth it. This one's called Standardization. Thank you. Right then, as is fucking customary, we're going to take you back, right fucking back, 31 years, to the very first Napalm Death album, Yes indeed, the title track of which is of course called
Scott!
Sometimes it's fucking incredible. Sometimes it's utter fucking shit. This is LIFE! A fascist inside your head. Fascist control! Two different songs. If you were fucking paying attention, you will notice the subtleties between the two if you listen closely enough. Piss off. Is that? All right then, it's time for a cover song, a cover song. Now then, you may or may not know that Napalm Death is influenced quite heavily by extremely violent Scandinavian hardcore punk music. So we're going to play something by a band that is the epitome of that, basically. This one originally by a band called Anti-Cymex from Sweden. This one's called Victims of a Bomb Raid. Thank you. We'll be right back. Nazi Cymex, boys and girls. Stick it with Eddie Gilweed's fucking cider where nobody else can see it. Scrumpy Jack. Sorry? Pardon? Oh, that's a bit fucking mutt. Right then, okay. Right, this next song is always quite topical. Especially as anybody from Ireland, women in Ireland, can now get abortions a whole lot fucking easier, which is fucking fantastic, as you said. Absolutely fucking marvellous. So, but we always return to a song about religious fucking interference inside there. Religious interference, in fact, everywhere. To commiserate with that, we're going to do a song from an album called Harmony Corruption. This one's a little number entitled Suffer the Children! We'll be right back. Thank you, cheers. All right. Thanks ever so much. We're gonna take the violent speed attack and pace down ever so slightly now. Play something a little bit more slow, gloomy, and perhaps introspective. This one's called Self-Betrayal. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, cheers. All right, thank you. Okay, thank you. I'd like to I'd like to speak about now. One of, I think, the most disgusting concepts that humankind has ever been involved with, and of course, created all by itself. Nuclear weapons. Now, the leaders, the people that pull the fucking strings, always talk about something called a nuclear option. How can these fucking weapons ever, ever be an option? An option is a choice. There is never a fucking choice to use these fucking things. Ever, ever in the history of humankind should there ever be that fucking choice. So this one, friends, is very much an anti-nuclear song. This one's called Call That an Option. Thank you. Thank you. Now, I may have made this general point when we played here last time, but this kind of thing is always worth saying again. Friends, I'm sure you would agree that each and every one of us in this fucking place deserves a life of dignity and happiness without harassment from any fucker else whatsoever. Agreed. And of course, as human beings, this should extend beyond these fucking boundaries, beyond any fucking ridiculous border you care to mention. A life of dignity and happiness for all human beings, without exception, is the very least we can expect. And in fact, fucking demand fundamental human rights, friends. This one's called How the Years Condemned Me. Cover song number two.
Dam Sugala.
Yeah, I know that one. Sorry, private joke. Right then, friends, by default, this next one, cover song, anti-fascist song, anti-fascist song. You know it by now, originally by a little band from California called the Dead Kennedys. You may be ever so vaguely familiar. And of course, in the spirit of friendship and solidarity, we'd like you to say with us, loud and fucking proud, Nazi punks!
Fire!
unless we all fucking think and keep on thinking. And again, Le Front National, fuck you. With fucking knobs on. And so, thank you. And so, we have almost come to the end of the night for us. As always, a big thanks to everybody for hanging around and watching, frankly, a load of old horrible fucking noise. Thank you. So, what we're gonna do to finish off is two songs back to back, until we see you again somewhere in a small French fucking village, hopefully. Take care of yourselves and everybody else around you, as fucking always. So this is Cesspits / Inside the Torn Apart. Good night, thank you.
Don't hesitate.
good night, thank you.